Welcome back to Electronic Beats TV. Here, Slices presents a feature with three successful protagonists who have come together to form a truly unique trio: Henrik Schwarz, Bugge Wesseltoft, and Dan Berglund. When this trio began, as they put it, their musical communication, a synergy was created where openness and improvisational energy was brought to life and then nurtured in front of an audience. Experimentation is always at the fore of everything they do as a group, and their intrinsically captured movements between jazz and electronics provide a delicately balanced oral aesthetic. We visited them in the beautiful setting of the Elmau Castle in Bavaria, southern Germany, as they recorded their new album. Please enjoy and make sure you're back for the next episode.
When it comes to the writing of the songs, also when I work alone, I just play something, improvise, and then afterwards you put a click over it. So that's actually in a way what we do. So I sample what they play, and then you just drop it into the sequencer at a random speed in a way, and then you listen. And there might be a line coming up by shifting the one to another place and by two tempos that overlap. And so you somehow, suddenly you create a line that no one would have ever played because it's in a way unhuman. And yeah, I like that a lot because it brings very new melodies into our music, like stuff that normally doesn't come from a human brain. Mm. And this is what I'm super interested in.
Ready? Time is money. Yeah.
So when we found something, I find it very joyful to play to them and then see them, these greatest musicians in the world, struggle to play that line. It's fantastic. Yes. And then suddenly they have it and it explodes. It's an explosion of energy. It's the best moment you can have. When yeah, I love it. that's the best.
We're having a hard time.
Yeah, but you, I mean.
God, you're there, Henrik is like.
I know you find it. I know you make it because, yeah, you can do it. I mean, who else can do it? If you can do it, then it's impossible. So I just wait. And then suddenly it's coming. And I'm like, yeah, man, this is something I haven't heard before.
When it comes to this trio, I really prefer to play the instruments. So I'm using the piano, Fender Rhodes, and either the Minimoog or the Prophet. So I have these three type of classic keyboard elements. And then it's up to him, because I think that's the combination of sounds where he can do the effect stuff.
And we are both in love with that. Because then it comes to analog and digital, because we are both convinced that they both get stronger if you bring them together.
Yes, exactly.
A grand piano is a fantastic instrument, but I think it's even getting brighter or more beautiful, the same with the bass, if there is some digital whatever signal combined with it. They both get stronger. The digital gets more beautiful and the piano gets...
The combination is ultimate for me. It's always been, since I started working with this in the early 90s with loopers and stuff, this combination of sounds, of that kind of digital world of rhythms and sounds, and that super organic acoustic stuff, it's very interesting for me. I love this, to bring this together. It's every aspect of it is amazing.
Thank you.
I use some effects on my bass, but I think I can do it without them. It's just, you know, like a guitar player, they use some effects, but they can play the guitar without all the pedals. So it's the same for me, but it's really fun and interesting to use effects on the double bass. I don't think it's that common to do it.
Most of the stuff has come through the concerts, I think.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Things we, because we record every concert, and during the concert there's parts that really turns out very well, and we listen to it and we say, yeah, we want to build that little thing we did there into a composition. And then starts all these problems, because you know, then you have to, what did I do?
Yeah,
what did
yeah.
we play there? And then you have to remember it, because I mean, me, I'm in my heart, I'm an
improvising musician, so my playing is about the moment, and so it's a bit difficult for me actually to redo stuff that I kind of did once. But just grab the moment. I think that's the, you know, the unique thing with jazz music.
We were trying to take it this one step further. We improvise, find something, but the improvisation is not enough anymore. So we sit down and then we're like thinking, so what do you like about this? What do you like about this? And then if we agree on something, that's gonna be fixed as one part of the song. And then we are struggling to really grab it. What is it? What is good here? Why is it good? And so we are trying to focus on that. So in a way we are collecting good moments instead of just improvising.
Very lucky that we mostly like the same parts.
Yes.
Yeah. Ah, this is great, and everybody agrees on that. So that's good. Makes it easier.
Especially the improvisation. It's like a good conversation. Sometimes you talk to people and you feel they're absolutely not listening, or they're talking all the time. You know, other times you meet some people that you feel a communication with, that you're really communicating. The speech is bouncing forth and back. And this is just like also when we play together on stage. Be listening to each other. Listening is the main ability, I think.
Yeah.
But that's again the same. It's the difference probably of good and bad music, or good and bad musicians. Good musicians, they have an ability to listen.